Klaviyo is an amazing tool for helping you personalize your messaging. And in today's video, I'm going to cover 5 ways that you can use Klaviyo to personalize your email marketing. So let's get into it. Hey, I'm Rod. Welcome to the channel. If it's your first time here, thanks for joining me. In today's video, I want to talk about 5 ways that you can use Klaviyo to personalize the messages that you send out. And the first one is related to segmentation. It allows you to group your customers using various criteria. It can be what they've done, if they've just visited your website or they've purchased something. You can segment based on demographic information, the locale that they're in, the city, the postcode, the country. You can segment based on a group of customers that have purchased products from a particular collection or category, or just specific SKUs or particular brands. And you can also drill that down further by saying, okay, I want to just create a segment based on these people that have only taken this action during this particular time frame. So it might be overall time, or it might be just in the last few weeks, might be between 2 specific dates. The second way you can personalize your marketing is by using dynamic content in your emails. So I'm going to jump on the computer to show you what I mean by that. Here's an example of an abandoned cart email. Some of the dynamic content is the name of the product, a picture of the product. We've also used dynamic content to create this buy now button based on the price of the product. So for every event that occurs, this one is the added product to cart event, there's a whole bunch of properties that you can access, which you can use as dynamic variables. And you can also create dynamic loops, like in this example where someone has abandoned their checkout. At the time that that occurred, there was more than one product in their shopping cart. So we can show all of the products by using a loop within the email. So there's the first product that they abandoned, and there's the second one. The third way that you can personalize your messaging is with personalization tags. So that can include things like someone's name, their location, the current day or date, the name of the product that was added to their shopping cart. You can use all of those as variables in an email that can be inserted into the subject or into the body of the email. Are you finding this information useful? If you are, I'd really appreciate it if you hit the like button. Thanks for that. Let's keep going. And the fourth way that you can personalize your marketing is with flows, otherwise known as customer journeys, otherwise known as automations, just depends on what system you're using. And you can use flows to send a series of messages to people based on a particular event that's occurred or some action that the person has taken. So for example, if somebody has visited your website, but they haven't proceeded any further, then we can create a site abandonment flow. This flow is triggered when someone is first active on the website. And we can configure it so that people don't receive this series of messages in this flow if they proceed further down the funnel. So if they enter the flow because they were active on the website, but then they actually proceed to look at a collection page or a product page or add something to their cart, then they get dropped out of the flow, and then other flows that are specific to those particular events then take over. And the last way that you can personalize your messaging with Klaviyo is using advanced automations. And what you can do with advanced automations is really just limited by your imagination. So for example, you may want to send a product recommendation email to someone who has purchased a product from a specific collection, but not from another collection. You may want to offer a complimentary product to someone who has purchased one product, but they haven't purchased the complimentary product yet. You may want to remind people to submit a review to your Google for Business page a few weeks after they fulfill their order. You may want to send further instructions or content videos to a customer to show them how to use or to make the most of a certain product. Just to recap, I've talked about 5 different ways that you can use Klaviyo to personalize your email marketing. Firstly, is segmentation. Secondly, it's using dynamic content. Thirdly, it's using personalization tags. Fourth is customer journeys or flows or automations. And lastly, it's with advanced automation. Did you find today's content useful? If you did, go ahead and hit the like button and click subscribe. I really appreciate that. If you've got any other content that you'd like to see me produce in the future, or you have any other questions, just drop them in the comment box below. That's it for today's video, and I'll catch you in the next one.